Now that we've found the distribution that results in our observed data, what confidence can we have that the beta parameter we captured is the true value? The answer is, it turns out, it depends on how much data we have. To understand why this is, let's consider the following. Imagine that the graph on the left and the right are going to show the PDF for a random variable x. Let's suppose the one on the left looks like this, and the one on the right looks like this. We can ask the question, what's the probability that the random variable x will be greater than a value t? For the graph on the right, more of the probability mass is over on the right side, so it's not surprising that the probability that x is greater than t is larger for the graph on the right than the one on the left. There is an inequality called Markov's inequality, which quantifies this notion. Specifically, Markov's inequality says that for any random variable x, the probability that it is greater than t is less than or equal to its expectation divided by the number t. Now, for the derivation of this, please see a link in the instructor's notes. Now, this becomes really interesting when you substitute x with x minus mu, meaning the mean value of x. That is, you can think of this quantity here on the right as x's deviation from its mean value. When you take this and substitute it into Markov's equality, it then becomes something called Chebyshev's inequality. Chebyshev's inequality says that the probability that x deviates from its mean value by an amount t is bounded by an expression described by its variance and t. This is actually really amazing and quantifies exactly the concept that we've been intuitively talking about. It says the probability that x deviates from its mean is directly related to its variance, and it's true for any random variable at all. Now, here's where we get back into thinking about our beta parameter from our exponential fit. Recall that if you have a bunch of data points, x1 through xn, and you suspect that they might be fit by an exponential distribution, the maximum likelihood estimation method says the way we get the beta parameter for that exponential distribution is to take the average of the values we've collected. Now, x bar itself is a random variable, and so we can reason about how much does the x bar that we've calculated deviate from the true beta value. And let's denote the actual beta value with a beta star. Now, to calculate this, we can just directly use Chebyshev's inequality. Now, all we're doing is we're substituting x bar minus beta star with x. If we do that, we have this expression: the probability of x bar minus beta star is greater than epsilon, is less than or equal to the variance of x bar divided by epsilon squared. And that number turns out to be less than 1 divided by 4n epsilon squared.